how many slices you think you will want, but my piece of advice is that have a bit more than you think you might need, because not every single slice will end up perfect and usable. Okay, you start off by cutting fairly thin slices out of your oranges, and if you saw that first slice that I cut, it wasn't perfectly round, and that is what I mean by them not all exactly ending up perfect. Also, what might happen with them is that some of them might actually burn in the oven, so it's always good to have some extra. As for the sort of end bits, I saved mine instead of wasting them, that bit that I just put aside there. And I used those bits for making glögg or mulled wine. So you can look up a recipe and use them, or you can use them for something else if you have another way of using them. So I don't know exactly how many millimeters wide mine would be, but maybe you get an idea from. So, next thing is you need your towel, and you are going to spread your orange slices on top of your towel. This is to get rid of the excess juices, the moisture from them, because if you don't, they would just take forever to cook in the oven. Dry, they're not cooking. You will fold the towel over and dab them down, pat them down, and as you can see, the moisture is starting to seep through the towel. You see the instructions on what to do, and my apologies, it probably wasn't the best possible way because I'm not used to doing voiceovers and I didn't really consider what I should say in the voiceover when I filmed these clips, so I felt like I didn't really have any chance in the start to be like, hey, welcome to this video. Here we are going to make orange slices. Like, I just had to jump straight in. But that's okay. We have moved past that part now. And you have got your basic instructions on how to make these orange slices if you wish to make them yourself. And what are we doing for the rest of the video? is when I started to notice that